Having read the phenomenally successful book, The Girl on the Train, by the same author, comparisons between the two books was inevitable. Hi guys! I am Sankalpita and you're watching Book Geeks India, which is a channel where I make book-related videos. So guys, if you like books, if you love reading, make sure to subscribe to my channel, like and share my videos, turn that notification on, and guys, please do comment. Because you know it that I love it when you comment, right? So I started reading Into the Water, keeping in mind my likeness for Paula Hawkins' earlier book, The Girl on the Train. Which was probably not such a good idea because I had my expectations raised really high and this book turned out to be remarkably different from the other book. So I wasn't as satisfied as I should have been when I finished reading it. Into the Water is the story of a small town called Bedford and the mystery which surrounds its waters. A few days before she died, Nell Abbott had been constantly calling her sister urgently, but estranged as they were, her sister Jules never bothered to lift her call and talk to her. A few days later, Nell Abbott is dead and it is said that she committed suicide. Unwillingly, Jules is dragged back to the town called Beckford and its mysterious waters, something which she never imagined she will do. She is afraid of the town, she is afraid of the house, but most importantly, she is afraid of the drowning pool, a place which surely has a lot of evil in it. She knows that Nell would have never committed suicide. She loved her life way too much to make it end this way. But when it comes to the drowning pool, no one can really know. For hundreds of years now, it has taken enough life to be considered unnatural. What is the drowning pool and what are its secrets? And what about Nell's death? What happened to her? To know this and much more about this interesting tale of darkness, evil, hope and betrayal, I think you should read the novel today. I am not gonna tell you. Now the plot of the book is a little complicated, characterized by a plethora of characters. There are so many of them that you will actually lose count. The book by no means is a simple read. It is a kind of book which makes the reader keep going back to the previous chapters to actually make sense of what is happening and remember what they had read earlier. The story is intriguing and mysterious, and the possibility of a surprise unraveling of some mystery will make you keep turning pages after pages even after your eyes are telling you to go to sleep. The only thing which I did not like about the book and did not like in a huge way was the plethora of characters. There are just so many of them, it is really hard to keep track of all of them. And right till the middle of the book, I was not able to remember each and every character, so I had to keep going back to the early chapters. I was having difficulty figuring out who was who and remembering who was who. A few of the characters though are really interesting and they keep the story going. I like the way Paula writes. Her writing style makes the mystery alive right till the end of the book. Her signature style of building up the intrigue quotient throughout the book was quite evident in this book as well. The narration of the book is from multiple points of view. So for example, the main character Jules, she has a narration in the first person, whereas some of the characters have third person voice. The climax was a little unflattering. Now I refrain from divulging more for the sake of spoilers, but it is safe to say that it was a bit disappointing. It simply did not do justice to the huge narrative buildup which preceded its unraveling. Also, I got an inkling of the end much before it was actually disclosed, so I cannot say it was really unpredictable. It was a little bit unpredictable, but towards the end, if you are somebody who can put two and two together, it became a little obvious. But guys, even though I've told you a lot about the book and its flaws, this book comes as a definite and must recommended read from me. It's a beautiful book. I have all these rantings because I actually expected something else having read Paula's earlier book. So guys, if you can read this book with a neutral mind without any expectations, I think you will enjoy the book. I did not do it and hence I regret it, and recommend you guys to go with this book with a neutral mind without any expectations, and I'm sure you would like this book. In the end, I rate this book 4.5 out of 5 stars, and I recommend it to all lovers of mysteries and thrillers, especially slow thrillers, and also to people who enjoy psychological thrillers. Finally, it's ratings time. So guys, all in all, I give this book 4 out of 5 stars. On characters, I give this book 3.5 out of 5 stars. On climax, 3 out of 5 stars. On writing style, 4.5 out of 5 stars. And also on entertainment quotient, 4.5 out of 5 stars. So that's it from me in this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, don't forget to hit that like, subscribe. And guys, please do comment. And until the next video, which will be pretty soon, bye.